had a dream, mother went to heaven, that's for real. Had the youngest singing, giving praise, thanks to him. I saw the party for real, had the glory you need. So what you said, hope, hope, heaven is holy. The man of old, in the crowns of gold. All chilling or feeling, riding the lots on throne. No wonder said, boy, come up. I woke up from sleep, only to see two black birds sitting on the wall.
Now there were two little black birds sitting on the wall.
Ladies and gentlemen, I greet you. Before I put forward my argument, I want to stand and make it clear that I stand for the fact that government's policies should significantly encourage bush burning. My learned colleague on the other side said that all our intellectuals are moving abroad. I don't think that is true. Our moderator here is a clear example of an intellectual who is in his country. So don't make it. Excuse me, my audience. Racial discrimination has been a fight that has been put forward by the United Nations, FIFA, and all world bodies. I want to say that if the third world countries restrict bush burning, then they are not in line with the United Nations goal of fighting against racial discrimination. So that the governments of third world countries should put in a policy like the subsidization of visa procedures so that people can lead the third world countries into the first world countries as their own support to the fight against racial discrimination. Again, in the sports domain, if you come back to our home country, you discover that most of our coaches have been foreign coaches. The major coaches have been foreigners. I want to say that if bush fallers were given the chance, or the prospective bush fallers were given the chance to go abroad and develop coaching skills, they will come back with a better position of taking the salaries paid to coaches and investing back in our countries, rather than paying whooping sums of money from our national income to foreign coaches who carry this money back to their countries as net property income from our country. So I believe that these individuals in our countries should be given the chance to go abroad and learn such skills so that they can come back and put it into our economies. And a great example is our president. Nation Building, a book written by Evangelist Bernard Etar, says that the ingredients for building a better nation are wisdom, passion, and vision. I believe that the individuals who are leaving the third world countries into the first world countries, they have the goal of getting knowledge and wisdom, because as one man has rightly said, wisdom and knowledge is the stability of this time. I want to say that if wisdom is acquired from the first world countries and brought back into our countries and put in place, we will have a better Cameroon and a better third world. I want to say that the government in this particular domain should put in a policy such as the facilitation of visa procedures so that these individuals can go to the first world country, and before we know it, they are back and they are investing. Again, we will discover that the movement of people from the third world countries to the first world relaxes the pressure on available resources. For example, the movement of a man here to overseas, he is left with a situation that on arrival there, he sends money to his relatives. This money helps them and reduces their pressure on their bosses for salaries. So I believe that the government should facilitate visa procedures, open more embassies for the first world countries, so that our country and the third world in general can be a better place. I stand here to support the fact that government policies should significantly encourage bush burning. Thank you.
I had a dream, mother went to heaven, that's for real. Had the youngest singing, giving praise, thanks to him. I saw the party for real, had the glory in me. So what you said, hope.
I think that we should revise our curriculums and make more practical systems of study and less theoretical, more professional schools. She's been saying that we should make loan schemes instead of scholarships to go abroad so that our population can be employed in our country. She's been saying that there should be seminars to teach teachers, so that they can teach students in turn, so that students know that the answer is in their country. She's also been saying that the social ease from bush falling, from encouraging bush falling, are so many. Fraud, the idea that you must succeed in another country, which makes you do all sorts of things, are bringing all negative things back, negative impact on the individual and on our society. Having said this, I'd like to react to some of the things the first speaker said. You talked of globalization and that bush funding is helping in globalization. And you said they don't need to be any international boundaries. You're so unpatriotic, and it's sad to see. What you're saying is that they should annul the whole concept of Cameroon. It should not exist. Because if there are no international boundaries, if there are no boundaries at all, then Cameroon cannot exist. And we are all Cameroonians. I cannot understand how a Cameroonian can sit there and say there should be no Cameroon. I also like to point out that you said foreigners' exposure to the global world can come if foreigners come. And we are saying the same thing. We are not saying that governments should not give chances for foreigners. In fact, we say they should uplift taxes, high custom duties, and encourage investments in our country. Our idea is all our efforts should be in our country, for our country, not where we are discriminated upon. Also, if the policies you talk about can give chances for us to govern and achieve the dreams, then these same policies can change the things in our country. You said heart transplants. And please, if we are not saying that policies should annul bush falling or people going abroad, and bush falling is going for greener pastures, how many of the bush fallers go for heart transplantations? Very few of them, I'd like to point out. Very few. So don't make heart transplantation look like everybody goes for heart transplantation. And even then, that is not bush falling. Because you are going just for medical purposes to come back to your country. It is not bush falling. Also, let me point out that the thousands that have gone, if they were bringing back, if all of them were coming back to our country, then we will have very comfortable situations now. And all of them have not come.
I had a dream, by the way, to have the dance for real. Had the youngest singing, giving praise, thanks to him. I saw the party for real, had the glory to me. So what you said, hope, hope, heaven is holy. The man of old, in the crowns of gold, all chilling or feeling right, the locks on throne.